I hear the crowd roar. Chant my name in the stands. I got drums, I got bands. Same ones that was hating, buying tickets, now they fans. Call a blitz, they don't see you, they gon' tackle your little man.
Get em.
Let's get activated, let's get activated. Let's get activated, let's get activated. QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me some.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. Pop out, treat this block like an end zone.
What?
Score. Check it. Benji calling money my ringtone.
Hundreds.
Or blue. Put her in the friend zone, she turned on.
More.
Ooh. Take one for the team, I'll do that for my boy.
Bread.
Game.
Time ticking. I'ma give it all until the last minute. Set up the block just for my man, I bet we win it. Go hard or go home, it's survival of the.
Today, from Allegiant Stadium in Las Vegas, Nevada, it's week 16 of the NFL on EA Sports. Derek Carr and the Las Vegas Raiders taking on Teddy Bridgewater and the Denver Broncos.
NFL football has come to Southern Nevada as we are in the menacing new Allegiant Stadium here in Las Vegas. The atmosphere here, electric. No matter the venue, the home folks love their silver and black. They are fired up as their Raiders get set to face off with the Denver Broncos. A little bit of daylight on that first down run. Sets him up nicely, 8 yards on the carry. The numbers a week ago from Melvin Gordon. 23 carries, 62 yards.
And I'm eager to see how they deploy him in this game. Last week, a heavy workload. Do they decide to bring that down a little bit and try and keep him fresh? Or do they say, guess what? He's locked in. Keep handing him the football.
Short yardage, Bridgewater. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete. On fourth down, here's Sam Martin on to kick it away. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. This is taken at the 15. And he's free going down. It's a foot race, and he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Mark that down as an 85-yard punt return, and the Raiders are able to strike quickly for six.
Hey, rookie, that's the way to make an impression. Return one for a touchdown.
Yeah, welcome to the party. We saw him fielding those punts before the game. Start the drive with a run by Gordon. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. They'll give it to Gordon out of the shotgun. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24. On third down, Bridgewater. And down he goes, brought down a Raider sack. Solomon Thomas, what a season he continues to have. His 15th sack of the campaign. Here's Sam Martin now. Remember, his first attempt was returned for a touchdown. Pulled in at the 24. A very good return that time. 18 yards. And the Raiders will take over now. Bridgewater. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. And this passing game's whole offense really didn't show up in the loss last week, and it hasn't started all that great here either.
Yeah, and they can't let that incompletion become an uh-oh moment. Like, oh boy, here we go again, just like last week. Each game is its own entity, treated as such.
And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Well, this defense for the Raiders, they were very strong last week in that win over Cleveland.
And every defensive team that we talk to, they spend a lot of time talking about creating turnovers. And anytime you get 2 or more in a game, you've had a really good performance. They exceeded that number in a huge way. They got the football back 4 times in the win. And a run like that shouldn't surprise anyone who's ever seen Javonte Williams play. Compact, strong, physical runner. He ran for 1,000 yards at North Carolina last year. In fact, there's over 1,100 and 19 touchdowns in addition. And that's despite sharing the backfield with another 1,000-yard rusher, Michael Carter, who's taken in the 4th round by the Jets. Najee Harris and Travis Etienne were taking over him. But many thought that Javonte Williams might be the best back in the draft.
And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. 2nd down. And after that play, we've got an injury. And it appears to be to Cortland Sutton. On 2nd down, Gordon once more. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half. And I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
The Broncos on 3rd down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. Bridgewater now. He's got his 6'5 receiver. That's Tim Patrick. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. It's a big play there for the Broncos. So after the big play, look at this. All the way down at the 15 now on 1st and 10. Now they run from the gun with Gordon. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Calling a gain of 4 on 1st, and that'll make it 2nd down. Now Bridgewater. Rush coming, and he's taken down. And the corner blitz gets him that time as he goes down for a short loss. It's one thing to be as disruptive as he's been all year. It's another to do it as a rookie. He might not only be a candidate for Rookie of the Year.
No, don't say it. Don't say it.
Defensive Player of the Year, possibly.
Yeah, and to do that, you have to be dominant from the first snap your rookie year, because let's face it, everyone devalues rookies a little bit or makes them work harder in order to get votes. Remember Ndamukong Suh's rookie year? I mean, he was everything that season, including first-team All-Pro. That's the type of year we're seeing here.
Down. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. So naturally, they will decline it. They got the 1st down anyway on the play.
Who needs a penalty when you picked up the 1st down through hard work and effort anyway? 1st down.
And a good pickup there. He gets about 6 up to midfield.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
On 2nd down, it's Williams. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. That's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to 3rd down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play and get my defense off the field.
Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
Oh, he's going to go ahead and field it from the 3-yard line. A very nice punt that time, but they get 11. Interception. Here's Bridgewater. Out quickly to Judy. And the Broncos are going to have a first and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line. First and goal, Melvin Gordon. And he'll wind up getting about 6 out of that, as that's going to lead us to the 2-minute warning. He'll get 6 on the ground. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth.
Yes,
and
he's,
and the Raiders have got him. Cleland Farrell. He's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thank you very much. Some critical games going on as teams fight for those final playoff berths. Let's get you around the NFL here in a busy Week 16. We'll get started out at GEHA Field at Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. And it's the Chiefs who have the lead in that one. Patrick Mahomes killing it. 3 touchdown passes. From there, we head east to Tennessee to check on the Titans at home in Nashville. And they were victorious in that one over the visiting San Francisco 49ers. Ryan Tannehill leading the way in the victory with 3 touchdown passes. Finally, let's get down to Houston. Check on the Texans at home at NRG Stadium. And they were losers in that one to the visiting LA Chargers. Justin Herbert, a strong performance there, over 300 yards passing with 3 touchdowns in the victory. In our game, it's been the play of Derek Carr that's led the way. His 3 touchdown passes have his guys out in front as we hand things back over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Bridgewater now looking to throw on first. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off at the 35. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Raider defense delivers a score. Now remember, this is the number one defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone. Not just stopping the run. Not just getting after the quarterback. But the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers, and they went after that one and took it all the way.
Back to it after the pick 6. Bridgewater. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. On second down now, it's Gordon, and he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right, it's been that way all afternoon. And down he goes, the pressure getting to Bridgewater. Carl Nassib, he's the culprit, causes a loss of 5, and it brings up 4th down.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big, and now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
Yeah, they just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche is coming right on top of it. It'll wind up being a net of 41. 9-yard return, 50 on the punt. They'll try to get this running game going with Williams. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down. The last run got a couple here, second and 8. Throwing is Bridgewater. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. The passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
Here's Sam Martin now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Fielded at about the 28. Take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Nearly a huge return as it is. They'll try and get the ground game going. Here's Gordon. He finds some way to turn this into positive yardage as he struggles forward for a pickup of about 2. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. This is Gordon as they go to him again. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. Now he's hit, and Bridgewater loses the football. And the Raiders pick it up. And he's into the end zone. It's a they'll start on the ground. This is Gordon on first down. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line. 3 yards remain for second down. Off the play fake, Bridgewater. And he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here. These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on third down. Outright, this one goes to Patrick. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield.
Well, maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I'm wondering if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game because that's worked well.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Denzel Perryman. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. Bridgewater now for Gordon on the draw. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. One quarter remains here in week 16. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Bridgewater's throw into the hands of Fant.
And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. Bridgewater on first down.
And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
To throw on second and 10, Bridgewater. That is taken in by the tight end Fant. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the Raiders 26.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They can go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10.
To throw, Bridgewater. Completes it to Fant on the right side. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. From the 3, second and a yard. Another tote for Gordon. He's been busy this afternoon. First down throw for Bridgewater. And they get to Bridgewater. Bridgewater taken down on the end zone for a safety. Things are just going from bad. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points. Continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Las Vegas, they are now 2 wins away from a perfect regular season as they move to 15-0.
And they will hit the road next week to take on the Indianapolis Colts. Meanwhile, for Denver, their playoff hopes take a big hit as they fall to 8-7. And they will try to get back in the swing of things next week on the road. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Celebration time tonight on the Strip as we say so long from Las Vegas.
Talking about making industry music. They want me to cap to y'all, but ain't gon' cap to y'all, cause y'all went up when they ain't had a ball. He tuck his 40, wonder how he felt watching his dog casket fall. I had to tell my wife to stop, he don't like to pass the ball. That chicken, he talking big hit, I was kicking in houses for it.